Madison Avenue, once considered the mecca of shopping in a city famous for selling the finest brands. But these sisters from Morocco who came to Manhattan for the luxury stores say not so much anymore.
All of these stores are closed and those that are open are like half empty.
It's like kind of sad.
When's the last time you saw this many vacancies?
Never. Never. I'm born and raised here, and I've never seen this many vacancies.
As real estate investor Sal Buscemi points out, even on Fifth Avenue, there are plenty of vacancies. And on Broadway, the homeless rest at the doorway of buildings that are for lease. Signs crying out for someone to take the space are seen block after block, with spray paint on the glass of locked-up stores that used to thrive.
The landlords are asking too much. That's really what it comes down to.
City Hall has taken notice of these empty storefronts, with the mayor saying he's considering a plan to penalize landlords who let the shop sit vacant for too long.
A vacancy fee or vacancy tax because they're looking for some top dollar rent, but they blight neighborhoods by doing it.
And we think it's short-sighted and doesn't necessarily understand what's going on. It makes no sense whatsoever for a landlord to keep their property vacant. 70 cents on the dollar is better than nothing.
John Banks of the Real Estate Board of New York says brick and mortar is up against increasingly tough city regulations and the convenience of online shopping. And as for those who say landlords purposely leave properties vacant to write off the losses,
there is no benefit to keeping your income low artificially. You don't get the tax break or the tax savings that people want you to believe.
No matter what's to blame for the blight, Buscemi says there's a bottom line to these sad-looking storefronts.
It looks like it's just, not open for business.
And that's not a good look for New York. Jessica Layton, CBS 2 News.